any lower than the one underwater where we started this whole mess, Yoshka.
Well, we're standing in it. But no, I never could have imagined that surviving droves of armed amphibians would lead us to where we are today.
Funny. I knew you would end up here from the start.
Could you sound a little more ominous next time?
Your tone does suggest you have more to tell us, Alia.
Does it now?
The light of the Sun King!
I'll be damned. It shines as bright as day.
How else would it shine, Yoshka?
You're ruining the moment. I know this statue is several unique dragons in a circle, but I like to imagine it's one circular dragon of many heads relieving himself after a large meal.
It could still be several unique dragons relieving themselves after a large meal.
Well, that's just disgusting.
Have we powered this up yet? Seems like that would be important.
A channeling crystal! I never thought I'd see one with my own eyes!
Intruders!
The legendary hospitality of the underworld is...
Let's see if they bleed the same down here.
Standing so tall, he brings hope to us all.
Something new has revealed itself. I think you'll like it.
intruders.
The legendary hospitality of the underworld is...
Let's see if they bleed the same down here.
Down upon you, now more than ever. Elia, are you alright?
I thank you for your concern, Chilop. But I assure you, I'm quite alright. You're on an adventure of a lifetime. Make sure you're equipped to handle it. Thank you. have a look.
This up yet? Seems like that would be important.
A channeling crystal? I never thought I'd see one with my own eyes.
No way through.
Do you suppose we could blow it up? That was so much fun back in the forest.
Thank you. As a team, we'll always make it out alive.
A moment, please.
She fell to the ground.
Alia?
Lying face down, she began to laugh. The old woman turned her head to the astonished faces of her companions. In mere moments, decades were removed from her face. And when she spoke, she sounded like me.
It actually happened. I am me again. I am home.
I don't understand.
Alia, you were of the underworld?
I told you, I was there when Thade attacked. I was part of his army.
I don't believe it.
And I fled. I wanted to live in harmony with humanity, not to enslave it, as Thade aspired to.
So you chose to stay in Orperencia?
When the battle concluded, I found no way to return to the gate before Ottila closed it. I was stranded. I used the last of my waning power to assume the form of a human woman. And for the first time in millennia, I aged. All I had to my name was this magic sack. Handed to me for use in the invasion, ironically enough. I assure you, it's yielded more weapons to fight the underworld forces than it ever did to support them.
Was that your intention? Or did you just see us as your best chance at getting back home?
Can it not be both? You must understand why I could not tell you this earlier. I have no secrets from you now.
I don't know that I trust you, Elia, but for once it does not horrify me to look upon your face.
I wish I could say the same of you.
In case there was any doubt, it's actually Elia.
I want to believe you, Elia, but how do we know that you won't turn on us now that you're home?
A worse threat than Thade already has the upper hand. His actions will not enslave the Middle World. They will destroy it. My conscience will not allow that to happen. After much consternation and debate, they agreed to have me along. Reluctantly.
So, you're a succubus then, Elia?
Are humans not capable of mentioning my species without using such a derogatory term?
I meant no offense. I suppose I am a bit sheltered still. I say from a palace made of glass in the underworld.
Lidert. I am a Lidert. Succubi are real as well, and similar. Some even more closely resembling me than other forms of Lidertz, to be honest. But I find being labeled as succubus insulting.
I'm frankly insulted that such a great insulter feels insulted by anything. And I can pick my nose, thank you very much. I'm quite good at it.
If we didn't know you so well by now, Elia, I would be inclined not to trust you. Neither succubus nor Lidertz are known for their honesty.
Yeah. And shouldn't you be trying to eat us? Or at least to, seduce us? I wouldn't mind the second one so much, to be honest. It has been a while.
Just a while? Don't flatter yourself, Yoshka. You're far too old-looking for me.
It's a rejuvenation chamber, and they're using it to speed up the incubation of dragonkin eggs, like the one over there.
That's one way to accelerate the breeding of an army.
The pipes above us channel the energy, but the power is not properly aligned at the moment.
Would it in any way benefit us to complete the circuits?
When a dragonkin is born, it is said to erupt from its egg in an explosion of dragon fire. The word hatch is truly an understatement.
If we can get it to just the right heat before this occurs, it could prove a useful explosive.
Sounds dangerous.
With proper timing, we could use it to destroy the gate to the second floor.
We'll only know if we try, won't we? We'll need to heat this just the right amount before we can use it on the gate to the next floor. We'll need to heat this just the right amount before we can use it on the gate to the next floor. We'll need to heat this just the right amount before we can use it on the gate to the next floor. We'll need to heat this just the right amount before we can use it on the gate to the next floor. We'll need to heat this just the right amount before we can use it on the gate to the next floor.
Say keep your guard up, but I just want you dead.
Thank you.
What did you discuss with Attila when we left you alone with him, Ilia?
Several things. But mostly, I just wanted to let him know I was there when he fought Thade. And I admired his heroism on the battlefield.
You couldn't have just said that when we were there too?
As I said, we discussed several things.
I'm curious. What other things?
The reason I spoke with him alone.
Point taken.